Welcome to my channel. Prepare to deep dive into the world of embedded PPDS as we explore its industry overview, uncover crucial insights on adopting PPDS functionalities within the core SAP system, along with integration strategies. This knowledge is invaluable for do well client interviews. If you find this video valuable, show your support by giving it a thumbs up and sharing it with your network. Let's not waste any time. Let's dive in. We are well versed in the essential master data, configuration settings, and PPDS functionalities. However, what you will discover here is a transformative increase in understanding PPDS. This video will comprehensively cover various system architecture approaches for PPDS implementation, the strategic integration of PPDS in the supply chain process, exploring alternative tools in the supply chain flow, market approaches for implementing PPDS, and real world utilization of PPDS tools in the current market landscape. In the extensive landscape of PPDS, numerous terms used in the market: PPDS, ePPDS, embedded PPDS, extended PPDS, and advanced planning, all touching the essence of embedded PPDS. Now let's get into the varied system architectures usual in today's market. First one, integration of ECC with APO PPDS. Second one, adopting embedded PPDS within S4HANA. Third one, leveraging ECC and S4HANA as sidecar. And the last one is the alliance of S4HANA, APO PPDS, and SAP IBP. Let's talk about ECC integrate with APO PPDS. The integration of ECC with APO PPDS represents a common architecture preceding S4HANA. ECC serves as the repository for core modules such as PP, MM, SD, and FACO modules. Meanwhile, within the APO system, modules like demand planning, supply planning, PPDS, and GATP stand available. The crux lies in the core interface responsible for the seamless transfer of both master data and transactional data between ECC and APO systems. SIF serves as the kingpin for the data transfer, be it for essential elements like plants, materials, vendors, or for crucial documents such as plan orders, production orders, and purchase orders. Activation of distinct integration model is imperative for this data transfer, requiring vigilant monitoring and queue clearing to address any rising issues. Let's talk about embedded PPDS. Within S4HANA, embedded PPDS stand out in its streamlined core interface, featuring simplicity as a key advantage. Remarkably, in most cases, it doesn't necessitate an integration model, though there are exceptions. Activating master data transfer primarily occurs at the master data level, while transactional data activation involves configurations. Despite this, data transfer between SAP and PPDS persists, come with vigilant queue monitoring. From my perspective, it remains two distinct systems, although interconnected. Let's dive into the architectural setup of sidecar. The fundamental modules remaining rooted in ECC, yet S4HANA seamlessly integrates with ECC, replacing APO PPDS. The scope of demand planning and supply network planning might transition to SAP IBP. S4HANA in this scenario serves exclusively for PPDS. The rationale lies in integrating PPDS without altering the core SAP functionalities into S4HANA. This prompts a query: why aren't the core SAP functionalities migrated to S4? Multiple factors come into play here, whether it is the absence of capital expenditure for such an investment or the business not being prepared for migration, among various other potential reasons. The last one is S4HANA integrating with APO PPDS. Within this structure, S4HANA takes over from ECC while APO remains the hub for PPDS functionalities. It is an operation model established in the market. This model involves integration models for data transfer, SIF, and monitoring activities. Additionally, other supply chain applications are tightly merged into S/4HANA's framework. Next topic is the strategic integration of PPDS within supply chain process. While PPDS functionalities primarily operate within the factory, it is crucial to acknowledge their significance beyond these boundaries. Understanding the external functionalities is key, but where does the input data for PPDS come from? It originates from plan orders. Yet, understanding how these plan orders are generated needs a dive into the supply chain process flow. Factories constantly produce goods, often referred to as SKUs or MRDS. Typically, factories are not directly involved in sales activities except for certain exceptions. The products manufactured in the factory are transferred to distribution centers where sales transactions occur. Sale orders are generated at the DCs. But how do products reach the DCs? They are either procured through purchase orders or stock transfer orders. Demand planning occurs at the DC level, while supply network planning determines the product quantity and transfer date from the factory to DCs. The output of this process is the creation of stock transfer orders, which represents the demand for the factory, and S&P plan orders are generated to meet this demand. These plan orders are the input for PPDS. S&P plan orders are generated within weekly time buckets, aligning with the available capacity for the week and placing the orders on a specific day. This is commonly referred to as rough cut capacity planning. The scheduling and sequencing of these orders are carried out in PPDS according to the business production plan. Subsequently, plan orders converted into production orders, which are then handed over to the production execution team for execution. Once manufactured, products are dispatched to DCs, becoming available for sale. Retailers or wholesale distributors serve as the end customers, and consumers like us purchase products from these retailers. This summarizes a brief overview of the supply chain process and illustrates where PPDS functionalities strategically fit within this flow. Additionally, PPDS also enables vendor planning. Next, exploring alternative tools within supply chain framework. Having examined the details of the supply chain process and its functionalities, let's now explore the array of tools accessible in the market for optimizing this process. The first one, ECC integrated with APO PPDS. The second one, S/4HANA integrated with IBP. The third one, S/4HANA integrated with Kinaxis. The fourth one, ECC integrated with S/4 PPDS and other third-party tools. And the last one is S/4 integrated with OMP. Within the ECC APO PPDS integration, the forecast emerges as the output of demand planning. Subsequently, during the supply network planning run, S&P plan orders are generated, forming the rough cut executable plan. These orders are then transformed into PPDS orders, initiating the scheduling and sequencing process. Next one is integration of S/4HANA with IBP. This functionality mirrors the ECC integration with APO. SAP IBP, unlike APO, doesn't generate plan orders. Instead, it furnishes product code, quantity, and date details to create plan orders. Reading and interpreting these details is crucial for generating plan orders within S/4. Some clients opt solely for demand planning from IBP, employing third-party tools for S&P. Next one is integration of S/4HANA with Kinaxis. Kinaxis performs both demand planning and supply network planning. Similar to IBP, Kinaxis doesn't directly create plan orders, but provides essential details for their creation in S/4. This tool sees widespread usage in the European region. Next one is integration of ECC with S/4 PPDS. Referred to as the PPDS sidecar, this setup maintains core SAP functionalities in ECC with S4 exclusively handling PPDS functions. Numerous alternative tools such as O9, JDE or AnaPlan are available for demand planning and SNP. The last one is integration of S4 with OMP. In this scenario, core SAP functionalities reside within S4 while OMP handles demand planning, supply network planning and detailed scheduling. This represents a subset of tools related to supply chain planning integrated with SAP. Feel free to share additional tools in the comment section if you are aware of any. Next topic is market approaches to implement PPDS. When clients migrate to S4 HANA from ECC, the shift isn't merely about transferring functionalities. It involves to address functional challenges within ECC system. Embracing S4 HANA is a forward-looking approach to facilitate business expansion. The discontinuation of SAP ECC support by 2027 is prompting business to migrate to S4 HANA. Engaging in the digital era enables businesses to leverage automation, AI, and machine learning. The adoption of S4 HANA involves eliminating third-party applications for improved integration. Standardizing processes through the implementation of a global template is a key aspect of transition to S4 HANA. In this scenario, businesses undertake additional steps to incorporate PPDS functionalities into their implementation scope. PPDS becomes a consideration if it is already in use within the existing ECC system. If PPDS implementation is a first-time endeavor, multiple discussions occur where businesses compare competitive tools with PPDS. SAP presents its case from a sales point. A thorough cross-checking process evaluates pros and cons for both tools. Businesses engage with SAP, sharing their day-to-day scheduling activities and pain points, seeking feedback on how PPDS aligns with their requirements. The inclusion of PPDS is depending upon the client satisfaction with this evaluation. Last topic is utilization of PPDS tool in current market. Typically, PPDS finds application exclusively within manufacturing facilities, often bypassing distribution centers. However, not all manufacturing units adopt PPDS. It is primarily complex manufacturing facilities that implement it. Let's explore the material types where PPDS is applied. PPDS predominantly serves finished products, although some clients extend to it use to semi-finished products. Additionally, a select few implement PPDS for critical raw materials. Now let's dive into commonly used functionalities. Standard planning heuristics, standard scheduling heuristics, setup matrix, optimization, campaign planning, alert monitor, and scheduling heuristics enhanced by critical attributes. Feel free to share your thoughts in the comment section if there are any other functionalities you utilize with PPDS. Don't forget to hit the like and subscribe button if you found this information helpful. Looking forward to seeing you in the next one.